And welcome back again, folks. I finished building the new light orbital lifter. It is, you know, same basic modular design. It's currently connected up and locked in. If you notice, I've got the extra bank of batteries on, a bunch of ions in, and some more powerful reverse ions. If it doesn't make it, then I can throw some more ions on it. Yeah, whatever. So yeah, light orbital lifter back up in decent condition. I decided to use this. It is something that I abandoned on my creative map. It was an attempt at a light Corvette, or not a light Corvette, but a heavy Corvette. So I'm going to be using it as the nose cone. Sleek. This is exactly what it's intended to be. Powerful, sleek, lots and lots of firepower. So yeah, temporary, have a projector up and running for it. Last episode right now is actually still compressing. Seriously? Well, I need some more stuff anyway. So yeah, the light attack Corvette space frame actually makes a fairly decent, I think, nose cone for a frigate. When, you know, doubled up like this. Because that's where it came from. Thank you. to stay 100% intact for what I'm using it for. But it will, at least... So, unlike the current AF, which has been somewhat decommissioned and is basically a platform, this thing's going to have 8 bow-mounted rocket launchers, partially protected by heavy armor. I'm going to be stealing, like I said, other people's scripting, because I've got a few ideas that are, well, new for me. They're probably not, they are definitely not new overall, but they are new for me. That is a turret control script, because I'm planning on building 2 big rocket turrets and putting them basically right here on each side. And they'll... I took a look at it, and the script is fairly straightforward. It uses a interior turret as kind of a dummy. Basically, the turret itself mirrors the actions and movements of the interior turret. Oh, come on. Thank you. So the turret will continue to mimic those actions. Even if the turret's empty, it'll still be able to fire. This episode will probably see me only finishing this nose cone part. Now, because those are important for heavy armor. Seriously? Actually, I'm going to do. Some more small tubes, otherwise, yeah. Okay. Here we are. Inventory. Spots for it. All right, we'll put another one here as a docking clamp. One motor, one steel tube, one construction component, and one steel plate. Switch lock. Thank you. It's only temporary. This is, I've got to completely redesign the damn thing. Slow. He don't want to move now. So yeah, all I need to do is be able to switch it back and forth between welder and... tiny bit over capacity, I think. Change that on there. Well, I'm out of steel grids, so let's load up a bunch. Still far too heavy. just some light armor bits, huh? Oh well, I'll cut them out and manually replace them with heavy at a later point. Wish this thing is, welded up enough to be a quarter of a million kilograms. Now that I've banged the side of this thing up against it. sit here for a moment while I go get a bunch of interior plates. Yay. More so than just that little tiny bit there. Load me out. Was that really a null spot built into it? power cells. 40 the next turn. Science, computers, small steel tubes. Nope. Computers and construction components. No steel tubes needed. Good. Batteries never hurt. Alright, well, I think we've got a reasonable start here. Now let's finish up what we need for these conveyors. More motors. Steel tubes. Lots of computers. Tons of computers. Hardly enough on the steel tubes. Still, get the computers laid in. because I need a metric crap ton of them. Yay. Alright, 8 computers and more steel tubes. Certainly is nice looking for definitions of going to ensure things die. To build than I do anything else at this point. Steel plates, 50 grids. construction components. That's why I hate using a projector. One of the reasons why I hate using projectors. Come on, stop frame rate. All right. small steel tubes. Exception of the gun turrets, I think that's it for that, so I'm gonna flush this stuff into here and cut it loose. There we go.
So what do you think? This is a nose cone for a brand new
frigate. And placing a script-controlled turret with two of these rocket launchers mounted on rotors on each side. Then immediately behind this section would be the small flight deck for all the drones. And then immediately behind that would be engineering. And then I can lay in the command center. Backup command center. Finish laying in the outer armor. So for right now, yeah, I'm satisfied with my work here. Next time you come on, you might see more stuff done with it. You might not. Alright, well, for now. And I'm going to leave this here. Actually, I'm probably going to disassemble it, actually. No idea why I kept on. more stuff later. Using a projector. In fact, I think I'm going to be using it to fire up the blueprint for an MSSV, and then I'll adapt the MSSV to a brand new rover, and thus send that pair off to the moons.
Everything else be atmosphere-capable stuff, such as the Lull March,
oh, I don't know, 50 or so. And I can build puddle jumpers using local resources. Actually, no. I think I'll keep it as a constructor instead of a deconstructor for now.
Alright, well, that's it for this one. I will see you guys around.